Greetings. I am not Dr. Sheldon Cooper, and welcome to the premiere episode of Not Sheldon Cooper Presents Fun with Computer Science. In Season 6, Episode 3, Sheldon received a requested box labeled Shelley's Preschool from his mother. He intended to find something worthy of a Nobel Prize from his works as a child, but he did not have time to go through everything, so after turning down Penny, he considered hiring a secretary for the job. So let's help him through the hiring process. Suppose we have three applicants. What would be the best strategy to select the best applicant? For once, we could, of course, interview every applicant and just select the best. But this is no fun, isn't it? So let's add a couple of considerations to make it more interesting. Firstly, immediately after the interview, the applicant is either accepted or rejected, meaning that after rejecting someone, we cannot come back in the future and try to hire them. Once someone is rejected, they are just gone forever. And secondly, our objective is to develop a strategy to select the best applicant with the highest probability. This problem statement is formally known as the secretary problem. So let's explore its optimal strategy. The optimal strategy for three applicants goes as follows. Reject the first applicant. And if the second applicant is better than the first, we accept him. Otherwise, we reject and therefore forcefully accept the third applicant. This strategy works by trading the first applicant in exchange for information, so that we have something to compare the other applicants to. Like this, we can make a more informed choice regarding the rest of the applicants. For a greater understanding, let's take a closer look at its permutation. In other words, every possible order in which the applicants can be interviewed. For example, in this permutation, we start by rejecting the first applicant, who is the second best. Subsequently, we also reject the second applicant because he's worse than the first. Therefore, we forcefully accept the third applicant, who is the best. By inspecting all other permutations, we conclude that in 3 out of 6 times, we do select the best applicant, which translates to a half and is significantly better than a purely random selection. But Dr. Sheldon Cooper is a very famous scientist, and he will surely get more than 3 applicants. So how does this strategy scale as the number of applicants grows as well? The optimal strategy for n number of applicants goes as follows. Firstly, rejecting first n over e applicants, which corresponds to roughly 37%. The rejection of exactly n over e applicants naturally has a mathematical reason, which I decided not to include in the video because it would greatly increase its duration. Nevertheless, I have listed a very nice explanation in the description. Secondly, accepting next applicant that outperforms any applicant assigned before. Let's take a look at an example. For visualization purposes, suppose that the first 5 applicants correspond to the first 37%, so we begin by rejecting them. After the assessment, we have also concluded that the highest performing applicant was a 7 out of 10. Now the idea is to find an applicant greater than 7 whom we are going to accept. So let's move to the 6th applicant, whom we assess to be a 5 out of 10. Thus he gets rejected, because 5 is less than 7. Now we move to the next applicant, whom we assess as an 8 out of 10. Because 8 is greater than 7, we accept him. With that being said, the probability of selecting the best applicant is again 1 over e, which is roughly 37%. And this is simply mind-blowing, because it is a constant probability. So you could have a billion applicants, and the probability of choosing the exact best one remains roughly 37%. You could go even as far as saying that using this strategy, there is a higher probability of choosing the best among 1 billion applicants than choosing at random between 3. This is very interesting, but could we apply this to another scenario? Perhaps instead of finding the best secretary to find your soulmate? Theoretically speaking, yes, of course. And Michael Trick, an operations researcher in his mid-20s, thought so as well. But because people will not endlessly apply today, at least me and Michael Trick, he proposed to alter the problem a little bit. Instead of n being the number of people we might date, n could be the timeline in which we will date. At the time, he reasoned that he would date from 18 to 40, so the approximately 37% are at 26.11 years of age. Thus, up to the 26.11 years of age, the idea is to date and reject everyone to use them as a mathematical benchmark. Then, you just find someone that is better than anyone you have dated before, and there is a 37% chance that her or him is your soulmate. So, when Michael finally found someone who was better than anyone he had dated before, he decided to propose. And well, he got turned down. But a few years later, in a secretary problem unrelated situation, he did find his present one, and is now happily married. This is only a friendly warning not to take this video as advice to your love life. With that being said, I hope that you enjoyed the video. Live long and prosper.